Hello, my dear students. Communicate your English. Unit 1, self-introduction. Today we are going to see how do you introduce yourself. When someone wants you to introduce in the meeting or during placement or any seminar, you need to prepare according to your personal details, and you'll have to present. Before you present, you need to practice 2 or 3 times in your home. And just listen, then I'll explain one by one. So today, self-introduction. Good morning, sir. My name is Meera. I'm 17. I am from Annanagar, Dharmapuri. About my qualifications, currently I am pursuing first BA English from JAM Arts and Science College, Dharmapuri. I have done my higher secondary from the state board with 77% and my strength is my positive attitude, punctuality, hard working and discipline. My only weakness is communicating in fluent English. I am trying to improve it. My hobbies are drawing, reading books, and listening music. That's all about me. Thank you, sir. So this is the way you need to prepare and present well. When you want to say good morning, you'll have to say with some pleasant in your face. Good morning, sir. My name is Meera. I am 17. I am from Annanagar, Dharmapuri. About my qualifications, currently I am pursuing first BA English from JAM Arts and Science College, Dharmapuri. If you are studying or if you are pursuing first BSc Chemistry, then you can say I am doing first BSc Chemistry from JAM Arts and Science College, Dharmapuri. I have done my higher secondary from the state board with 77% or even actual percentage, and my strength is my positive attitude, punctuality, hard working and discipline. So when you want to say that positivism with you, you'll have to say positively. So, and my strength is my positive attitude, punctuality, hard working and discipline. My only weakness is communicating in fluent English. When you want to say your weakness, you'll have to say slowly, not like a positive attitude. So my only weakness is communicating in fluent English. I am trying to improve it. My hobbies are drawing, reading books, and listening music. That's all about me. Thank you, sir. If madam is there, say, good morning, ma'am. If you want to introduce in the afternoon, good afternoon, madam. If it is in the evening, a good evening, sir. Good evening, gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Try to modify yourself. Next one, we shall see with the language teacher in the staff room. You want to meet your language teacher in the staff room. How do you introduce? Good morning, ma'am. I am Tamil Vanan from First English Literature. I am fortunate to pursue higher education I desire. I have offered English literature as I have an intense liking for the subject. I personally believe that English does not pose any danger to the growth and development of our languages. English today is no longer the language of particular people of country. English can aptly be called a global language. Would you mind giving some important advice about my attitude towards language learning and making a plan for improvement? Could you please suggest some important things I can do my own to improve my English, spoken English in particular? So you would like to meet your language teacher and you would like to help your madam or sir to help in improving your English, especially spoken English. You are seeking suggestions from your staff. How do you approach? So start with good morning, madam, as usual. If your faculty is a sir, then you say good morning, sir. I am Tamil Vanan from first English literature. If you are from English literature, first BA, then you can say first BA English literature. Or if you are from computer science, first BSc computer science, you change the department. So I am, here spoken form, short form am. Short form, I am. So I, apostrophe, M, Tamil Vanan. You have to say am, not am, the spoken form. This is a spoken form. I am Tamil Vanan from first English literature. I am fortunate to pursue higher education I desire. Whatever I like, that I have been given a very good opportunity. I am fortunate means here opportunity, chance. So I am fortunate to pursue, study, doing, you can change. I am fortunate to pursue higher education I desire. I wished to pursue first English literature. Now I am doing. I have offered English literature as I have an intense liking for the subject. I like English very much. Now I have been given my desire. So I have offered English literature as I have an intense liking for the subject. I personally believe that English does not pose any danger to the growth and development of our languages. If I study English, no way that will affect mother tongue or any other regional languages of this country. So you are assuring. English today is no longer the language of particular people of country. No one can claim English is my language. So it's a global language. English can aptly be called a global language. Would you mind giving some important advice about my attitude towards language learning and making a plan for improvement? So you need to seek madam's suggestion. When you want to seek any suggestions, you'll have to start like this. This is a gentleman English or a professional English. Would you mind giving some important advice about my attitude towards language learning and making a plan for improvement? Could you please suggest some important things? So this is a gentle way of asking madam. Since they are all learned professors, you need to request. Would you mind? Could you please? This is a gentleman English. Could you please suggest some important things I can do my own to improve my English, spoken English in particular? So this is the way you need to introduce when you want to seek any suggestions from your faculty members. With the fellow student in the canteen, think that you are chatting with your friend in the canteen. How do you chat? How do you discuss with your friends? With the fellow student in the canteen, there are two persons involved here, A and B. So first person, well, now what would you like? So you need to start with the well. That means everything is going on well. Well, now what would you like? Other person is responding the question, baked fish, I think, with the chips and some salad. And your friend is suggesting baked fish. It's a prepared one, fish, fried one, prepared one, baked fish, I think, with the chips and some salad. You would like to have fish along with the chips and some salad, vegetable salad. And you are asking a question, won't you have a first course grapefruit? Now you are suggesting, you would like to have first course grapefruit. And you are asking like this, won't you have a first course grapefruit? No, thank you. How your friend is refusing? No, thank you. So you'll have to thank him for his suggestion. But I would quite like tomato juice instead of grapefruit. I would like to go for tomato juice. Right. Immediately you'll have to accept. Right. I'll have mushroom soup to begin with. And then a couple of mutton chops with the boiled potatoes and green peas. The first one, you need to start with some salad and some fruit. Also, you can have soup, mushroom soup or vegetable or non-veg or any other soup you can suggest. Right, I'll have mushroom soup. So to begin with, and then a couple of mutton chops and boiled potatoes and green peas. These are the things you would like to have. That is your suggestion. And how your friend is suggesting, other person, shall we have some fruit custard? That is a mixed egg and milk custard for dessert. That means a dessert food. And you are suggesting they make a rather nice fruit custard here. So custard, okay, but they won't prepare well. Instead, you can go for, but I'd rather an ice cream. So you would like to have ice cream instead of custard, fruit custard. And your friend, what kind? Strawberry, chocolate, vanilla. These are the varieties of ice cream. You know very well, you are all well versed with that. All this ice cream, strawberry, chocolate, vanilla. Vanilla with the chocolate sauce, please. And you have accepted your friend's suggestion, vanilla with the chocolate sauce, please. And you are asking sauce also. And last one, your friend. That's a good idea. I'll have one, two. So your friend ends the conversation. I'll repeat. A, well, now what would you like? B, baked fish, I think, with chips and some salad. A, won't you have a first course grapefruit? B, no, thank you. I would quite like tomato juice. A, right. I'll have mushroom soup to begin with and then a couple of mutton chops with boiled potatoes and green peas. B, shall we have some fruit custard mixed with egg and milk for dessert? A, they make a rather nice fruit custard here, but I'd rather an ice cream. B, what kind? Strawberry, chocolate, vanilla? A, vanilla with chocolate sauce, please. B, that's a good idea. I'll have one too. So this is the way you need to have a conversation with your friends. With the students, volunteers of your club, team, group, etc. So this one, how do you address the gathering of students, volunteers of your club, team, group, etc.? This is a rare opportunity, so you'll have to impress the gathering. Respected volunteers of youth club, team, group, and dear friends. So you'll have to address them. How do you address? How do you start? Respected volunteers of youth club, team, group, and dear friends. I'm Meera, daughter of Mr. Rahu and Mrs. Rajeshwari from Matlambatti in Dharmapuri district. My family is poor and landless. I am 20. Our family was in a bad financial situation when I was born and could hardly manage two meals a day. As a baby, I developed rashes all over my body and my family had to spend a lot of money for my treatment. My mother says that my sister felt so desperate and asked my mother to poison me and put an end to our financial trouble. She argued that the whole family was under debt because of me. When I was studying in third or fourth standard, my father contracted tuberculosis and we had to take him to Salem for treatment. My studies were affected by this and I failed continuously in school. Later, I learned driving and worked as a taxi driver earning ₹600 per day. Now I am a TN STC driver in Dharmapuri earning ₹20,000 a month. I am leading my life peacefully. Where there is will, there is way. And this is your personal story. Just assume that this is the way you suffered a lot in your life. So how do you narrate your story? Of course, this is a narration only. So start with the respected volunteers of youth club, team, group, and dear friends. Meera, daughter of Mr. Raghu. When you want to introduce your father, you should have title Mr. For your mother, Mrs. That means married. and you'll have a title for your mother, Mrs. I am Meera, daughter of Mr. Raghu and Mrs. Rajeshwari from Matlambetti in Dharmapuri district. You can change your father's name, your name, mother's name, and your hometown and your district. My family is poor and landless. No land, very poor, opposite to rich. I'm just 20 or 18 or 22. I am 20 year age. Our family was in a bad financial situation when I was born, and I could hardly manage 2 meals a day. Usually we go for 3 meals a day, whereas because of their family situation, hardly they had only 2 meals a day. As a baby, I developed rashes, some patches there in the body. I developed rashes all over my body, and my family had to spend a lot of money for my treatment. Since I suffered because of these rashes, my family spent a lot. My mother says that my sister felt so desperate and asked my mother to poison me and put an end to our financial trouble. Already my elder sister suffered a lot, and she would like to poison me. That means committing suicide. She argued that the whole family was under debt because of me. Since they spent a lot, they have gone for some debt loan, financial assistance from others. When I was studying in third standard or fourth standard, my father contracted tuberculosis, TB. He could not breathe well, tuberculosis, you know. And we had to take him to Salem for treatment. For treatment, we need to take from Matlambetti to Salem. My studies were affected by this, and I failed continuously in school. Because of my father's illness, I suffered a lot, and that affected my studies also. Later, I learned driving and worked as taxi driver, earning rupees 600 per day, and started earning in driving some companies. Now, I am a Tamil Nadu State Transport Corporation driver in Dharmapuri, earning rupees 20,000 a month. I am leading my life peacefully. That is will, that is way. That is a very good quote. Now, with the chief librarian, we have library in our college. How do you introduce the library? With the chief librarian. Okay, we'll continue. Okay, we shall continue with the chief librarian. The new library provides open shelf system. Students can move around the shelves and pick up the books they would like to have. Before that, we shall start this conversation with the chief librarian. Good morning, sir. I am Kannan. One cannot imagine a college without a good library. You have an important role to play in the effective functioning of the college library. You have the essential skills to guide and support the library users' learning and helping them to develop as independent readers and learners. The shifting of the college library to a space is all is commendable. The old building was quite cramped. It did not provide enough space for books, nor did it provide reading room facilities. The new building is quite spacious. The new library provides open shelf system. Students can move around the shelves and pick up the books they would like to have. Library is a storehouse of knowledge. The library must maintain a list of all books recorded in the catalog. Books of all subjects must be arranged in an alphabetical order. It will help the needy and diligent students in shaping their bright future. would you mind helping students their goals, sir? And you are meeting a library, the two chief librarian. There are number of persons in the library, chief librarian. So how do you start? As usual, good morning, sir. I am Kannan. One cannot imagine a college without a good library. If at all an institution, college, we should have a library, that too very good library. It's a house for knowledge, storehouse for knowledge. So you have an important role to play in the effective functioning of the college library. You are suggesting to the librarian how a college should be. You have the essential skills to guide and support the library users' learning and helping them to develop as independent readers and learners. If at all readers, students or learners, if they visit library, you'll have to guide them, you'll have to help them in what way they can browse, in what way they can utilize the library effectively. The shifting of the college library to a spacious hall is commendable. Now you are appreciating the library. I think that library has been switched over or moved from old building to new building. The old building was quite cramped, so populated and highly more number of students. Very difficult to accommodate. The old building was quite cramped. It did not provide enough space for books, nor did it provide reading room facilities. The new building is quite spacious. You are appreciating big building, new building, very big hall, highly spacious, that can accommodate any number of students. So you are appreciating. The new library provides open shelf system. Previously close to one, we need to go and ask the librarian to open and search. Instead, now they have open shelf systems. Students can move around the shelves, shelf singular, shelves plural, and pick up the books they would like to have. Library is a storehouse of knowledge. The library must maintain a list of all books recorded in the catalog. Books of all subjects, they must be arranged in an alphabetical order. It will help the needy and diligent students in shaping their bright future. If one wants to shape their knowledge, his or her knowledge or bright future, they'll have to utilize this library in a useful way. Would you mind helping students their goals, sir? So you are suggesting and you are asking the librarian to help. At a competition registration desk. So next to one, think that some competition will be held, and how do you register? How do you approach the registration desk in the reception, in the entrance area? At a competition registration desk. Good morning, sir. I am from Mangarai, Dharmapuri district. I am 17. I am pursuing first BA History from Jaya Marsden Science College, Dharmapuri. I am worth paying attention to swimming competition. I would like to take part in a swimming contest at Olympic Games. I have won the inter-university journal level competition. At the Olympic Games, our representatives are in with the best swimmers from all parts of the world. Swimming across the river makes me different from other swimmers who like to swim only in swimming pools. I request you to kindly register from other swimmers who like to swim only in the swimming pools. I request you to kindly register my name for the ensuing swimming competition. So you would like to take part in the swimming competition. How do you approach the desk? How do you request them to register your names? Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, sir. I am from Mangarai, Dharmapuri district. I am 17, 18, 19. You can change your age. I am 17. I am pursuing first BA History from Jaya Marsden Science College, Dharmapuri. If you are doing commerce, then you can say I am pursuing first BCom from Jaya Watson Science College, Dharmapuri. I am worth paying attention to swimming competition. I have been training. I have been practicing for swimming. So I am worth paying attention to swimming competition. I would like to take part in a swimming contest at the Olympic Games. So you plan to take part, participate in the Olympic Games. Now you would like to practice. I have won the inter-university zonal level competition. You'll have to tell them in what way you have achieved already. I have won the inter-university zonal level competition. At the Olympic Games, our representatives are in with the best swimmers from all parts of the world. So you would like to join with them. Swimming across the river makes me different from other swimmers who like to swim only in swimming pools. Whereas my friends are the competitors, they may swim only in the pools, not in the rivers. So swimming across the river makes me different to other swimmers who like to swim only in swimming pools. I request you to kindly register from other swimmers who like to swim only in swimming pools. I request you to kindly register my name for the ensuing swimming competition. Let it be others, they can swim there in the swimming pool, but I would like to swim in the river. More challenges are there, and this is the way you need to go approach help desk, and you can register in it with a guest at college. Good morning, sir. I'm Ravi. I'm doing first BCom in Jam Arts and Science College, Nallano, Dharmapuri district. Also, I am the secretary of the college. Our college is holding its annual sports day function on the 24th of this month. On behalf of the sports club, I invite you as the guest to conduct and also attend the other function at our college. We have made all the arrangements for your travel and stay. I request you to oblige me by agreeing to be the guest on this occasion. Kindly confirm your assent so that I can make a mention of it on the invitation card. So this is the way you need to introduce. This is the way you need to invite a guest for some competition or a program or a cultural program or sports day, annual day, let it be any other function. So good morning, sir. I'm Ravi. I'm doing first BCom in Jaya Arts and Science College in Nallano, Dharmapuri district. Also, I am the secretary of the college. Being a secretary, you can invite the guest or president or any other position. Also, I am the secretary of the college. Our college is holding its annual sports day function on the 24th of this month. On behalf of the sports club, I invite you as the guest to conduct and also attend the other function at our college. You are invited. We have made all the arrangements for your travel and stay. If it is from any other town or city, Chennai, Coimbatore, Salem, you need to arrange for his travel and stay. So you are assuring. We have made all the arrangements for your travel and stay. I request you to oblige me by agreeing to be the guest on this occasion. Kindly accept my invitation. I need to mention in the invitation. So kindly confirm your assent so that I can make a mention of it on the invitation card. So this is the way you need to invite the guest. Do well, practice well, try to listen this video module again and again. Definitely you also introduce yourself without any struggle. All the best. Thank you.